House Republicans today voted to make National Public Radio private. Correspondent Molly Henneberg looks at the largely symbolic action.
Today, the Republican-controlled House approved a measure, 228 to 192, with one voting present, to stop taxpayer dollars from funding National Public Radio, NPR. The legislation also prohibits public radio stations from using federal dollars to pay NPR dues or to buy programming. The GOP sponsor of the bill says a government, trillions of dollars in debt, should not pay for, quote, non-essential services.
We live in an age of digital radio, computerized digital streaming, commercial all news radio and radio talk shows, many of which are also streamed on the internet or over satellite radio. And these provide sources of news and opinion without federal taxpayer dollars. NPR should do the same.
Critics say the bill will prevent smaller public stations, especially in rural areas, from having the funds to buy popular shows. One Democratic congressman suggested sarcastically that the GOP wants to put NPR's Car Talk guys out of business.
The American people are not concerned about jobs or the economy or what's going on around the world. They're staring at their radio saying, get rid of click and clack. Finally, my Republican friends are doing it. Kudos to you.
NPR came under fire again last week when a conservative activist released this undercover video of then NPR executive Ron Schiller.
It is very clear that we would be better off in the long run without federal funding.
Republicans who believe NPR leans left say they're glad to make that happen.
Why should we allow taxpayer dollars to be used to advocate one ideology?
But some Democrats say NPR is a, quote, voice of reason.
I refuse to scapegoat the National Public Radio, a reasoned and responsible voice for the people.
The bill is not likely to get past the democratically controlled Senate. And even if it did, President Obama is not likely to sign it. In Washington, Molly Henneberg, Fox News.